Hey guys, this is Attack on Samurai. Here's a Wi-Fi battle against Maria, aka Mienecho. So this isn't my first battle with Maria, aka Mienecho. I'll just call her Mienecho because that's what he's called on Hayden Manor stream. By the way, if I sound weird during this video, it's because I'm a little sick. My allergies have, acted up and stuff, so I should be fine. I'm not gonna die or anything. So, anyways, this is a new team I have. It's a Mega Aggron team. With, of course, Mega Aggron, Darmanitan, Florges, Crobat, Porygon Z, and Dragonite. While Mienecho, he has Landorus, Rotom Wash, Ferrothorn, Latias, Volcarona, and Mega Lopunny. So this was my first battle with this new team, I think. So Darmanitan is just my pivot Pokemon, like, you know, it goes for a U-turn and switches out for me, so I can get a free switch in and stuff. So that's what Darmanitan is there for. Florges is my healer. Mega Aggron is my defensive wall. Florges is my special defensive wall. Crobat's there to get rid of Seltorox because since Darmanitan is a Focus Sash, the Seltorox, if Seltorox are up, it's gonna, break its Focus Sash and all that stuff. And it'll also break Dragonite's multi-skill too, which I really don't want, so. Yeah, his team actually gave me quite a bit of trouble, especially that Ferrothorn. That Ferrothorn, even though I have a Darmanitan, the Ferrothorn and the Rotom definitely gave me trouble. Those two paired together are really good together, so. Yeah, so I'll show you what happened. I don't remember everything that happened in this battle because it was quite a while ago. But yeah. So I decided to start off with my Leo, my Darmanitan, as he leads off with his Lopunny. So I'm pretty sure he wanted to get the fake out off right away. So I decided to switch out, not wanting to take that damage and potentially break my Focus Sash and go into Aggron, who is my defensive role, which can take Mega Lopunny's attacks easily. So yeah, he's gonna Mega Evolve this Lopunny. He's gonna go for Fake Out as I thought, so it's gonna break my Sturdy, but it doesn't really matter since Aggron is, since I'm gonna be Mega Evolving Aggron. So yep, there's a Mega Aggron, and now he's gonna go for the Power Punch to try and get to plus one. He gets to plus one, so that way you can try and, kill me with a high jump hit, but I'm not gonna let that happen. I decided to go for the Stealth Rocks here, get up some free, rocks and stuff. He switches out, goes into Ferrothorn, so, yeah, I think I went for Thunder Wave here, or I went for Dragon Tail. I went Dragon Tail, okay. So I went Dragon Tail to try and get myself in a decent position, because I didn't want, Aggron to be in there with the, Ferrothorn. So yeah, the Dragon Tail lands, and Ferrothorn is gonna, make me take a little bit of a Iron Bark damage, which, kinda sucks. So Volcarona is here now, which honestly isn't the best position for me. Even though it's good, because, Seltorox are up, so Volcarona is gonna be at half. But, because of the lefties, it's kinda gonna screw me over a little bit. So yeah, he goes for the Fiery Dance on the switch in. And Dragonite doesn't take any damage from that, which is really nice. I believe he's gonna switch back in the Ferrothorn, I think, probably. Let's see, I think he does. Okay, no, he goes into his Landorus, that's fine. So Landorus is here, he's gonna bring me down to minus one, which does suck, definitely. I go for the D-Dance, it doesn't really matter. No, it matters, I guess, if he was Scarfing or not. I don't think he was Scarfing. Yeah, he's a Scarf, he's actually Scarfing. So, Yeah, the dance doesn't really matter, because that just by seeing leftovers tells me that he has probably some kind of bulky set or something. Because Dragon Claw still do a lot, but you know, I don't know. So he goes for the Stone Edge. He does a lot to Icarus, my Dragonite, unfortunately. So that means I'm gonna have to sack Dragonite here later on in the match. So I go into my Porygon Z. He goes for the U-turn, I guess, breaking the switch in or just wanted to get an upper hand. He goes for the U-turn, does quite a lot to Porygon Z. His Landorus T's attack is like really bad. It's like base 445 or something like that. Like, that's ridiculous. That's at least the highest of most Megas. Like, I'd probably say it's relatively close to Mega Lopunis' attack, which is like 136, I think. So, yeah, it hits really hard. So he brings in Latias from during the U-turn, goes for the Beefball, which does suck, because that means that when Volcarona comes back, it's not going to take any stealth rush damage, unfortunately. So I get the Tri-Attack here. Rotom Wash ate that up pretty nicely, unfortunately. So, yeah, I don't get any, burn or whatever, unfortunately, from that Tri-Attack, which is fine. I go into my, Florges here. He goes for the Pain Split. I guess predicting Florges to come in, and he got it right, so Florges took some Pain Split damage, which, again, does suck, and Rotom's pretty much back to full health, which, again, not the best position for me. So he goes for the Volt Switch now. I believe he goes into Landorus here, I think he goes in Landorus. Let's see, I think it's Landorus. Nope, it's Ferrothorn. Okay, never mind. So that kind of sucks for me. I go for the Wish. I don't know why I did. I think that was for Dragonite to come in. But I think he's going to predict my switch into Dragonite and pretty much kill it off. Which, again, that was very obvious. So for him to do that, that was, like, I guess a really good play. So I'm going to end up losing my Dragonite to that, which, again, really does suck for me. And he didn't have any other option either way. I guess he could have went Lucid if he wanted to, but, you know, it doesn't matter. So he's going to Protect, and I bring in my Darmanitan. I think I go for Taunt? Yeah, I went for Taunt, so he saw my Taunt, which really sucked, because that's what I wanted to happen to that, Fortress, I mean, Ferrothorn's Fortress. But, yeah, unfortunately that didn't happen. I go for the U-turn, brings it down a little bit, just a little bit of chip damage is alright. As I go to Porygon Z, so yeah, not a bad, I guess, switch in for me. So I believe he switches out, goes back into the Porygon, I mean, he goes back into the Rotom, I think. Yeah, he goes back into Rotom. Again, going for Tri-Attack, it's not going to do that much. Even though, actually, I think that did about half that time, so that was actually a high roll. When I got before, it was a low roll, unfortunately, so. Yeah, I'm gonna go for another one, try and at least get something, just some kind of, I don't know, residual damage, but, I mean, get some kind of, like, burn or whatever, but fortunately, I don't get it. Tri-Attack did do a lot, though, but he's gonna end up both switching out, going into the, Ferrothorn, which, again, I'm in a bad position. This Ferrothorn and that Rotom are really messing me up, like, really badly. He goes for the Stealth Rocks here, I think. No, he goes Lucid, actually. He goes Lucid, probably predicting my Darmanitan to come in Fire Breath, which does suck for me. He's gonna get his lefties back and get to full health, unfortunately. As I believe he goes back into... No, he goes into Rotom to sack it. So that was a good play, going for that. Sacking the Rotom. So I believe I go for a U-turn here, I think I go U-turn. But because of a Leech Seed, I believe Rotom is actually unfortunately gonna live this U-turn. Yes, it does, unfortunately. Like, you can barely see it, but it lived about like one. And when that happened, I was like so... I was really mad, because that, I should have died to that U-turn, but he got the Leech Seed, so that was good for him going for that play, bringing it to him, and knowing that he would probably live it too. But yeah, so Latias is here. Latias can pretty much go for whatever it wants to, Psycho Cut, whatever. I think I'm gonna predict the Psycho Shot. Yep, I predicted it. I think I'm gonna switch out, predicting another one and going into Aggron, I think. Yeah, going to Aggron here. So he's gonna go for the Slash Drop. Of course, Aggron's gonna live it pretty nicely. I mean, it's gonna take it very nicely since Psycho Cut, since Psycho Shock hits on the physical side. He's gonna go for a Roost, get up to about almost full. And I believe I go for the Thunder Wave here to slow him down, which was, you know, a good play for me. Very good play. So I believe right here he goes for a Draco. It lands. It's gonna do a lot of damage since Aggron isn't especially defensive. But it's actually gonna live it though. It's gonna take it pretty nicely. It's gonna, not nicely, but it at least took it somewhat well. So yeah, I go for the Dragon Tail here. And it does quite a lot to the Latias, which is definitely really nice. He goes into Lando. Good play for him. Because now I'm going to be pressured to switch out. And I believe I go back into Porygon Z after this play, I think. Or I sack Aggron. No, I switch. And I think I go back into Porygon Z. I go into Forges,
okay? He goes for the EQ. I believe right at this point, I'm pretty much trying to get Forges back up to a decent amount of health so that I can move another Earthquake. I'm just gonna keep trying to get up to full health. He goes for Cellcrocs here, good play. I think I went Rush. Yeah, I went Rush, so he probably predicted the Rush and went for the Cellcrocs, which again, good play for him. I'm gonna try and Wish Pass this onto an Aggron, but Lando is just gonna pretty much pressure me to not do it, so I'm gonna protect, get some lucky, and also get the Wish health back. Which again, really does suck. I'm pretty much giving away, I'm not only giving myself health back, but Lando's getting health back as well. Which really isn't a good position for me, really not. And I don't really have to switch it either, because Lando's attack is like monstrous, so I'm gonna just kill like pretty much everything on my team at this rate. So yeah, I'm just gonna try and, it's not stalling, really. I'd say it's not stalling. It would be stalling if I go for toxic or something like that. Which I don't think my opponent does anything. But yeah, I'm gonna protect again, go for another wish. So use the EQ of course, and we're gonna get a wish health, and I'm also gonna get some lucky as well. But Lando's pretty much back to full because of what I did, so. Unfortunately, Ford just can't win this Starboard here. So Ikus, he's gonna do, still gonna do a lot. Gonna wish. I really wanna try at least like two of them, maybe like two or something like that. But yeah, I think he's lucky to get a nice really back to the world. So, yeah, this is a war I can't win for just unfortunately. Rangers is just too powerful. It's really hard to beat this thing, it really is. Literally, my team doesn't really have the checks for it, I'd say. I just pray on.
G does, but I have to try and like play around it somehow. Yeah, I'm gonna go into keys. I think I pretty much just sack it because I can't do anything. Or I try to go for. But I think I went for default, if I remember correctly. I think I went default. Yeah, I went default. I think he just predicts that and goes for Cellthrox again. I think. Or he went for a knockoff. No, I went U-turn, okay. So he went for the U-turn. Crobat's gonna take some decent damage. But again, not that much. So, yeah, he's gonna switch back into the Ferrothorn, which again, I really can't do anything to at this point. I still have Darmanitan in the back to somewhat deal with it, but it's just like those two, being the Landorus and the Landorus and what's it called, like really pressure Darmanitan, like really. It's really hard to try and get damage on it. So, he went for Leech Seed on my switch in, and I'm going to switch out their Manitan, going back into the Forges. I think I tried to predict him to switch out or something, but unfortunately he did not. So, he's just going to stay in with this thing, and I'm going to try and double switch, I guess. Maybe hoping that he would switch into something else, which he does not. He goes for the Gyro Ball, he's going to do a lot. And yeah, it does a lot to Darmanitan. So yeah, I think he just goes for, yeah, he goes for this, pretty much sacking it now. So that was a really good play on Mineko's part doing that play. So yeah. now Rotom is gone, which is I guess really not good for me at all, because I really can't do anything. So he's gonna bring the Megalopony back. Of course, I'm expecting the fake out, so I'm gonna switch back into Aggron to somewhat take it. He goes for Power Punch instead, predicting Aggron, so that was a good play. Or something like that, whatever it was. But yeah, he goes for another one, he's gonna take out Aggron. I pretty much can't win at this point now, because one, Crobat outspeeds me. I mean, Lopunny outspeeds Crobat, so a return is definitely gonna kill, I think. Yep, it kills. So all I have left at this point is Porygon Z and Florges, which again can't really do much with these two because Ferrothorn just pretty much walls both of them, which is very unfortunate for me. I go for the Tri-Attack, kills off his Latias, which again doesn't really matter because I pretty much knew at this point that I lost. He played it really well, like he played this battle really well. I just feel like he predicted my every move and stuff. Like, Mienecho is a really good player. Heading up for the fake, I was gonna do a lot to Florges. He's gonna do quite a lot to it, fortunately. So I went for Wish or Protect, one of the two. But again, it doesn't really matter. He's gonna go into the Landers, and I think at this point I'm just like, okay, I'm done. I'm not doing this. I go for the Moonblast. Doesn't do that much to Landers, so that told me that he probably had a little bit of special defense on him, maybe, because that did like almost nothing to it. So yeah, he's gonna go for Stealthrocks. I don't really know what was the reason for that, because, well, I guess he wanted to just make sure that Darmanitan would die, I guess. So, alright, I guess it's not a terrible play on this part, but still, it just felt kind of weird to do that. But yeah, so I pretty much protect. I shouldn't have done that, but I guess I wanted to get to a decent amount. I need to get back to a decent amount so that I can live the Earthquake. But in all honesty, I probably should have went for the Moonblast, because I really couldn't do anything at this point. So, and I don't think the Moonblast would kill anyone. He goes for the EQ really a lot. I go for the Moonblast. It is able to take out the Landers, so I made it a 3-0, which was, you know, again, not bad. It's not bad. But this team just wasn't really bad. Today's gonna go into Volcarona. Volcarona pretty much just sweeps the rest of my team now. So, got rid of Florges. Florges can't live it. Oh, actually, no, it lived it. Okay. I actually didn't think it lived, but alright. So, he lived it, I guess. But again, I can't really win this. I mean, I can't win this at all. He set the Stealthrocks, so Darmanitan's gonna die to Stealthrocks, and yeah. I go for Protect, I guess making him go for another attack, but he does, actually. I thought he would have went for a Corvid Dance, but I guess not. He's gonna get some lefties back, which is good for him, I guess. I'm gonna get some lefties back as well. So yeah, he goes for a Corvid Dance now. I guess maybe predicting my switch into Porygon Z or something, but whatever. But I'm gonna go for a Moonblast. It's not gonna do anything at all. Really, it's gonna do only one damage. Yeah, I did nothing. I did manage to get the special attack drop, but it doesn't really matter at this point. Mienecho, he played this battle like really well. My team, I felt like, probably wasn't like, when it came to the Ferrothorn, I really didn't have like a lot to deal with it. All I had, well, I guess actually I did have a lot. It's just that his Rotom, and I want to say Rotom and Lando, those two stopped me from trying to take out the Ferrothorn. But Yeah, so he's gonna go for the fiery dance, he's gonna take out Porygon-Z, and I think I'm just gonna just forfeit, I think. I think I forfeit, or I just let my Mons die to Seltharox or whatever. So yeah, Bastille's coming in. I can't take a fiery dance at plus one, so yeah, I just give up. Just give up on that. So yeah. Good game, Mienecho. Really good game. I feel like maybe I could have played that better, maybe. Or he was just like too good, but it's all good. It was a good game, so yeah. So thank you guys for watching, and I will see you in a another Wi-Fi battle. Oh yeah, one more thing. If you remember from I think my last Wi-Fi battle, or maybe it was my second to last one. I had talked about the OBA league and stuff, so they actually found more players, need more coaches for it. So that means the it's gonna start soon. So can't wait for that. We'll definitely record that stuff. So yeah, I'll see you guys in the next Wi-Fi battle.